My Pillow founder and CEO, Mike Lindell, has been out and about making the rounds in the media promoting what he believes is going to be a cure-all for COVID-19, a drug that, by the way, has not yet been approved by the FDA for anything at all. It's actually made from a toxic plant. The drug is called Oleandran. And he believes, and has been touting as such, that this thing is going to be able to cure, possibly prevent, COVID-19. And so he went on CNN with Anderson Cooper to talk about his miracle snake oil. And Anderson Cooper promptly called him out, not just for being the snake oil salesman with this thing, but then started actually calling him out for other things that most people weren't aware of. It was beautiful. Take a look.
I am just telling you, this is the answer. Wouldn't you want to save lives? Sir, this is what my heart is. I gave it to my friends and family.
Wow. You really are like a snake oil salesman. I mean, this is, you could be in the old West standing on a box telling people to drink your amazing elixir.
I give the glory to God.
No,
I do what Jesus has me do. I give the glory to God. And I want to help people.
Jesus
I'm not money driven.
Remedies that are not remedies because they've never been tested.
I am not money driven. And why would I do this? Ask yourself why I would ruin my reputation.
You don't have a great reputation.
Well, I mean, you know, that's, I mean,
you
if you say
that,
I'm going to pray for you, Anderson. You're in my prayers, Anderson, because they destroyed me when I went all in for this great president. That's what it was. I was on the Better Business Bureau of Minnesota going after you because you support Trump. I was up for their torture award, their highest award they give to the best companies
as soon as I went all in for the president,
the Better Business Bureau lowered me from an A-plus to an
A. Sad.
It is sad that companies do stuff like that out there.
For you to lie like this is really extraordinary to me. The Better Business Bureau looked at your advertising. I'll stand by the truth, and that is the truth.
Okay, so that was nuts. Let's be honest here. That whole exchange was rather crazy. For those who are wondering why Mike Lindell says, I'm just out here, I'm doing whatever God's telling me to do. Mike Lindell had a religious awakening. He had been addicted to drugs for many years, got clean, found religion, and he credits that with keeping him clean. So good on him for that, right? We're absolutely not going to shame anybody for that. But that, just in case you're wondering why he's saying all this about God is sending me out here, it's because he believes the religion helped save him from the life of drugs. He went on to found MyPillow. He's made millions of dollars. And he's also faced many, many lawsuits over false marketing claims. That's what Anderson Cooper was talking about. And some of these I actually knew about, but I didn't know the extent. Folks, this man has been sued so many times because he and his company are essentially total frauds with everything they say in their commercials. Now, the one I knew about was the early days of MyPillow. All the commercials said you buy one, you get one free. And then you go and you look it up and the pillow is $100. Like, holy crap, it's $100. But you get two. Well, it turns out the price of each pillow was actually just $50. So that is not, in fact, buy one, get one free. You're paying for two and you're getting two, but they're making you think it's a good deal even though they just doubled the price. I don't know. So I knew about that one. I knew they had to pay out for that one. But here's some other ones. Investigators say the company also touted MyPillow as the official pillow of the National Sleep Foundation, but failed to disclose its financial connection with the group as required by law. Because the National Sleep Foundation is a made-up thing by these companies. They created it. National Sleep Foundation, unfortunately, folks, does not exactly exist. That claim is still on the company's website, but under the settlement must come down by the end of January. This is an old article. In agreeing to the settlement, MyPillow admits no wrongdoing. The penalties include $100,000 in charitable contributions. This is with regards to the lawsuit that Cooper was specifically talking about. MyPillow still faces two class action lawsuits over its marketing. One complaint filed in California cites claims that inventor and founder Lindell was a, quote, sleep expert, when according to investigators, he has no expertise in sleep science or medicine. They actually had to investigate whether the guy was a sleep expert. Now, I want to know how that investigation went. Like, I really want to know what it takes to qualify as a sleep expert, but more importantly, what it qualifies to not be considered a sleep expert. I mean, I know there is a science to it. I know there are medical professionals that devote their careers to sleep. But at the same time, dude, you've been falling asleep every day of your life. You should know at least a little bit of it. You know, maybe not a sleep expert, but at least, you know, a sleep, you know, I can't think of the word right now, but, you know, master. You don't have to be expert level, but you probably mastered sleep at this point. No, I'm just messing with you. The point is, they've lied. This company has lied to you from day one. And the other claim, California investigators also say MyPillow promoted the product's ability to solve sleeping problems, such as insomnia, snoring, neck and back pain, but there is actually no evidence to back those claims up whatsoever. So the question is, why is all this important, right? Lindell's not out there promoting MyPillow. He's out there promoting a medicine, again, made from a toxic plant. So if this thing is not made properly, this could end very badly. Could also be fine. They make medicines and foods out of toxic plants all the time. So sure, I'm sure it's going to be safe from toxins. But the question is it actually going to do what it says? Recently, Lindell became a board member of Phoenix Biotechnology. And this is the company that is making this Oleandran drug. They're the ones putting it out. Lindell's the one out there hyping it. But this is the same Mike Lindell. This is why I went over all the fraud. This is the same Lindell that did all of that, that continues to do all of that. So if we can't trust him with the claims he's making about a friggin' pillow, how in the hell, why in the hell should we ever trust this man when he's talking about a medication? I wouldn't. Not at all. He has lied about the efficacy of his products in the past. He has lied about the science. Lied about the science behind his pillow. And we're supposed to take his word that this compound, this chemical compound that his company is creating is somehow going to cure COVID or cure anything else. No, that's dangerous. Believing this man is dangerous. Trusting this man is dangerous. This man, for his other company, by the way, also, as Cooper pointed out, has an F from the Better Business Bureau. This company that he is running is ripe with fraud, corruption, and abuse. We have seen that in the lawsuits. We have seen that in the settlements, though they have admitted to no wrongdoing. The facts don't lie, though, folks. The facts don't lie. And that is why I personally would never trust any kind of miracle cure or drug that this man is selling. He has a history. He has a history of being dishonest. He has a history of being sued for these things. His company has a history of lying in their marketing materials. This is not the kind of company that we should be trusting. He is not the kind of guy we should be trusting. And any medicine that he pushes out should probably, you know, not be trusted. He's created a pattern of behavior here, and he has not shown any signs of changing that particular behavior. And that's what's troublesome here. Anderson Cooper was right to call him out on this. That was a beautiful job by Cooper, by the way. I just hope enough people see that to understand that, yeah, you've got some medical companies out there doing some great things trying to come up with cures or treatments for this devastating disease. But you also have a lot of charlatans out there claiming they're doing the same thing. We need the media to actually do its job and find out which is which.